If you've got a lot of trees on your property, a chainsaw can be pretty useful. From pruning, felling them, or cutting up firewood, a chainsaw will tackle those jobs easily. You've got to know what you're doing when you use one, and most importantly, you've got to stay safe. I'll take you through how to choose a chainsaw and how to use it safely. Chainsaws come in a variety of sizes. There's different bar lengths, different power ratings, plug-in, battery, and petrol-powered models. It all depends on what you're going to be using it for. For example, will you be pruning, chopping, firewood, or felling trees? Corded electric models are now quiet and low maintenance. They're fine for smaller projects and generally light cutting. The battery versions are also quiet and they give you great mobility. Battery technology has come a long way and these chainsaws can now handle all types of jobs from pruning to cutting up firewood, no worries. They're low maintenance and all you really need to do is keep the blade sharp and keep them topped up with chain bar lube. And then there's the petrol powered models. They run on a two-stroke petrol oil mix and will give you plenty of power. If you're going to be doing more heavy duty or professional jobs like felling lots of trees, then a petrol model is the one you're after. Now let's take a closer look. Here's the chain which moves around the bar. On the chain are the teeth which obviously do all your cutting. Now you can adjust the tension of your chain here by turning the screw. Now on some models you'll also find the tension screw just on the inside, or you may even have a larger hand turning device which tensions the chain as well. As a rule of thumb, there should be no gap between your bar and the chain, and you should only be able to see half the guide teeth. So this is set pretty good. Remove this cover here to change your chain or your bar. Always make sure your new chain is on the right way. The pointy bit of the teeth should be facing forward. Chain lubricant goes in here. Here's the chain brake, which stops the chain from spinning. You can push it forward to stop, and it'll also engage if the chainsaw kicks back when you use it. Kickback happens when the nose or the upper tip of your chain comes into contact with your wood and throws the saw upward and backward towards you, which is pretty dangerous. This is where the chain brake is pretty handy. It'll automatically engage if the kickback is severe. Chaps, boots, a helmet, gloves, ear and eye protection will all help you keep safe. And make sure you're not wearing any loose clothing. And if you're using an electric plug-in chainsaw, make sure you use an RCD. And make sure to power off when adjusting the chain. Here's how to start a petrol-powered chainsaw safely. Check your premix petrol ratio is correct for your chainsaw and ensure you've got chain bar lube before you start. Start with your chainsaw on the ground with nothing obstructing the bar and chain. Push the chain brake forward so your chain doesn't rotate when it starts. Prime the engine as per instructions. Engage the choke. Place your foot on the rear handle. Steady it with one hand and pull the cord with the other. If used properly, a chainsaw can safely cut logs of a diameter double the length of the bar. With battery models, it's a whole lot simpler. Place your battery in the chainsaw, engage the safety button, then push and pull the trigger. When cutting, make sure the ground is clear and you've got a firm foothold. Pull the chain brake back towards yourself before cutting and make sure the chain is running at full speed. Always cut with the lower end of the bar and in a downward movement. Once you've cut all the way through, engage the brake. Make sure your chainsaw has come to a full stop before placing it on the ground. Take the cover off and make sure it's clean. Some tree sap can damage the chain if left on it. And it's always a good idea to sharpen your chainsaw after every use. To see how to sharpen a chainsaw, check out our video online. Now you're armed with all the info you need, it's time to pop in a store and choose the right chainsaw for you. If you like what you've seen, subscribe to the Mitre 10 YouTube channel for more handy content or click here to watch some now.